Hello guys, my name is Manish Gaur. I am from TKR College of Engineering and Technology. Here we come out with a new video as a part of Vocal for Local campaign. This campaign is supported by Samskriti Foundation, a renowned non-profit organization. Ever wondered the food product which you eat fills your stomach but also the pockets of the foreign company? And in return, we may have little or no effect on our economy. In this video, we will take you through the reality of the food products which are dominating our market and their countermeasures. We will also discover how important it is to choose what we eat and how it impacts on our economy.
Hey guys, I'm Kavya Maragoni from TKR College. So today, before I start to speak, let's have a quick look into what effect does Indian food manufacturing units have on our economy. Well, Indian food manufacturing industry and the grocery market holds fifth place in the world, contributing up to 70% of the sales. Well, Indian food industry is the sixth largest in our country and it holds up to 32% of the sales. And Indian food marketing is expected to reach 61 lakh crore rupees by the end of 2020. And it's the sixth largest, be it for consumption, export or even production. Well, let me explain you how the niche of food processing works. A famous MNC comes to your locality and opens a supermarket. It opens employment for workmen and suppliers. The local suppliers supply their products for the proposed bulk rates to the company. The company takes them, process them, packs them in an attractive way and puts them in the mart. People buy these products and it's overwhelming to find the price difference of the same product in a local shop. Sounds confusing, right? Well, in short, these MNCs buy raw material from us at cheaper rates, process them and sells them back to us. They earn good profits by this. Moreover, they employ our people and selling of these products, launching of new ones, goes on and on and on and on. At last, our people are left with bare four-digit salary and these companies play monopoly in millions. Let us have a deeper insight on this topic.
Hey guys, thanks for staying with us. My name is Mohinuddin and I'm from TKR College of Engineering and Technology. Now, I'm going to share some stunning facts with you, so please pay attention. As research says that every 10% dietary increase in packet snacks, fizzy drinks and sugary cereals and other highly processed foods boosts the risk of cancer by 12%. Another research says that there has been seen 11% increase in breast cancer and it was directly related with consumption of mass-produced processed foods. And it is research also says that 10% increase in consumption of processed foods increases higher risk of cancer in every age group of people, be it breast cancer or colorectal cancer. A study says 93% children eat packaged food more than once per week. 56% children eat sweet food items such as ice cream and chocolates more than once a week. 59% children aged between 14 to 17 years eat packaged beverages and cola at least once a day. 83% children drink milk food items which are processed. 69% eat cornflakes, Kellogg's Chocos or whatever it be, cereal sugary type for their breakfast before heading to the school. 91% children carry their lunch box filled with processed food, and almost daily children and youngsters are being served of new types of processed food. Let me say a name of few brands, hope you identify them: Pepsi, Mirinda, Mountain Dew, 7-Up, Tropicana Juices, Uncle Chips, Quaker Oats and India's favorite crisp Lay's and Kurkure. Have you heard of them? Yes, you have. And also you have tasted them. But do you know the strange fact they all belong to one company? Sounds strange, right?
Yes. Right from 7-Up till Quaker Oats, all of these products are manufactured by one company. And the name of this parent company is PepsiCo. PepsiCo manufactures every beverage we find in a supermarket. And just imagine how much revenue does PepsiCo make out of our pockets. Let us give it a number. As stated by the Economic Times, PepsiCo made a revenue of approximately 6,000 crore in the last financial year. Imagine guys, 6,000 crore from only our nation. And what is the reason behind it? It is us who are prone to these products, who cannot finish our parties without these products. Packaged food has all overtaken us, and packaged food has dominated our market. So please think twice before choosing. Please think twice before buying a product, because our economy will be barely affected with it. The companies play monopoly in millions but pay us bare taxes. So please be vocal for local. Thank you so much.
Hey guys, thanks for staying with us. I'm Suma from TKS Set. The statistics we mentioned before are just the tip of the iceberg. The data is likely to be far more disturbing if we examine a thorough case study on junk food consumption in India by compiling this year's data. While doing a deeply extensive research, we came across many such alarming facts. So this is why this campaign is very important for each and every youth out there. Now, what to be done is think twice and choose wisely before you buy a packet of chips or a bottle of juice. Do you know our Indian snacks are sold internationally and have high demand in foreign market? We are home for many snacks, right from khara, murukulu, aloo bhujia, sev and whatnot. Our Indian culture has got 10 times more different types of snacks than the number of chips in a packet of Lays. Be it the sweetest lassi or refreshing majjhika or the all-rounder roo afza, these nutritious drinks cannot be compared to any of those bottled juice or drinks. So guys, think twice before you buy. Be vocal for local. Stay local, stay healthy and safe.
Hey guys, please like this video before leaving, and please make sure you subscribe our channel, and please hit the bell icon for new updates. It motivates us to make new videos.